This quite small painting, when it's hung in the gallery, is invariably one of the most popular paintings here. It's by Sir Joshua Reynolds, and it shows a young mother, ostensibly, and child. It's bred legends, all popular paintings do, and the legend is that this is Emma Hart, later Lady Hamilton. She had already at this point been the mistress of Sir Harry Fanshawe, but had been evicted from the house, having had an illegitimate child. Reynolds, story goes, would have painted her in about 1782. Eventually, little Emma, the child, was packed off, and Emma Hart went on to conquer Lord Nelson and Sir William Hamilton on the way, becoming Lady Hamilton. Well, it's difficult to tell, really, isn't it? It could be her. But one of my predecessors, Denning, who was an early keeper of the gallery, records it in one of his notebooks as a woman from Scotland, and just noted that it was very much rather more like a couple of sisters, really, because the woman was so young. Well, who can tell? Frankly, everyone who loves this painting tends to love it for the wrong reasons. Looking at this painting, one tends to think not of Reynolds, but of someone like Renoir. It has impressionist ideas behind it, so people think. It's so vague, so poetic, so charming. The reason it looks like that is because Reynolds was a wicked man where technique was concerned. He would dip his brush into anything that he thought would make a painting look like a real old master. And many of his techniques were absolutely ruinous. The standard joke about Sir Joshua Reynolds was that his portraits died before the sitter. And this was because he used ephemeral, evanescent pigments with glazes, or he would dip his brush in tar. Frankly, he would have dipped his brush in his breakfast porridge if he thought it would give the look he wanted. This painting, in fact, is not a proto-impressionist masterpiece. It's a total wreck. Interestingly, it was given to the gallery in 1836 by Sir William Beechey, the great portraitist. And Beechey had ostensibly saved this painting by painting on the reverse. By sealing the back of the panel, he hoped to preserve this, which was already a wreck, even then. And he painted a portrait of Sir Francis Bourgeois, our founder, on the back. And to be perfectly frank, in many ways, I'd rather we were looking at the portrait of Sir Francis, because I have to explain time and again to heartbroken visitors to the gallery about the painting's terrible, terrible condition. However, people love it. So maybe, in a curious kind of way, Sir Joshua Reynolds' aim has been realized. He wanted it to look like an old master, and amazingly, that's kind of what it's become. It looks at least 300 years older than it is, just because of its ruinous condition.